Hi guys, we Bob here. So today we're talking about how people think digital art is actually made. So let's grab those fancy digital wash brushes and ping, we have ourselves a background. We can then take our sandcastle foreground brush and just wave it backwards and forwards like a little Hogwarts wand. Professor McGonagall would be proud. The software even signs our paintings for us with our own name and everything, and we can even use voice commands like give me the magical mountains in before we're even finished. The software knows what we want. So now we can add some character with the spicy brushes and we've got a hero, we've got stories, we've got mountains. We just let the software do the finishing touches and within less than a minute we have our painting ready for sale. Obviously I'm joking, and most of this work takes hours and hours of actual painting. I think the Star Wars picture took me about 3 or 4 hours, I think. So this is a popular YouTube short meme, and I thought of it after someone posed me an interesting question. Now I've been doing digital art and animation for well over 15 years, mainly the art for about 6 years, but before that I was doing a lot of animation apps. And I've seen and heard people say digital art is not real art. I can only compare this type of statement to the frustration that all artists get when you're asked, can you draw me? Yeah, but it will cost you some money. What do you mean, you won't do it for free? So it was interesting a few weeks ago when I got a comment from a person by the name of Keith, and Keith kindly asked, and I will paraphrase, with the more realistic simulation of watercolour, especially in the likes of Rebelle, does it mean there's more things to tweak and therefore makes the process quite complex? So in essence, this could lead to the question, is digital art more complex than traditional art? And we're going to explore a wee bit of that in this video. There is a second question, and that was, can I follow a traditional painting tutorial on a digital platform? And to answer that, we're going to follow a traditional tutorial, talk about the previous question in this video, and see what the outcome is between Rebelle 5, Sketchbook and Krita. So I decided to follow along to a real life tutorial by Mako. She has almost 2 million subscribers. She's an artist, she does watercolour, and her videos are very good. I'll leave a link in the description to the specific video that I was following along to. I broke it down into steps and I'll put them on the screen briefly. For our digital art process, we set our paper size at about A5 and then we follow those steps that we had before in our own digital way. So the first step that we can't follow is wet the paper unless we're using Rebelle. And I'm going to do a video probably in the next coming weeks on those kind of features that Rebelle bring to the table. As we can't wet the paper, we're going to put all the colours up to step 10 on the image. So that would be the oranges, the reds, the blues, as you can see me doing in the example provided. And all I'm doing is using this one brush, and it's in the textured watercolour brush set, which again, link to the sketchbook brushes is in the description below. We can then blend these colours together to achieve a similar result to that Mako achieved. And as you can see, the results from Rebelle 5 and the result from Krita. We can then start adding our island in the background, and this is done with a muted orange colour to just show those shapes in the distance. We can add darker areas to show the objects closer to us, so the forest, the bushes, and we need to reflect those brush strokes as a reflection in the water. So in the words of R2-D2, bleep, bloop, blop, or boop, or if you're getting some value from this, please hit the like button, it really does make a massive difference to my channel and I really appreciate it. If you've got any questions like Keith did, put them in the comments below. I will get them and I will answer them, or I will make a video about them. So using a darker blue colour, we can add waves and we make them larger closer to us at the bottom of the page and smaller as they go towards the island in the distance, or longer, shorter. You can blend some parts and then add finer detail as I'm showing you, and just experiment as I did. I did this 5 times. I did 5 different versions of this drawing just to find out how the process worked and could I mimic a kind of watercolour look, which I think we've achieved in the end. We can then add in the boat, a figure, a boat person, and what is their story? What story are we telling? Are they out in the water in the morning? Is it their daily routine to go out in the water and do the fishing? Are they going to an island offshore to meet some people? It's nice to add a story and trying to think to yourself, what does my picture tell the story of? And to finish it off, we can add some sprinkles of white, and I sometimes use a different layer for this. I'll add a layer above, similar to waiting for the page to dry in real life, and then you can put on your gel pens, etc., or splatter using a paint brush or using a toothbrush. In our case, we use a splatter brush, which is in our set of brushes available to us. So to answer Keith's question, I don't think there's much difference between the complexity of traditional art and digital art. Both require paper, brushes, paints, and different techniques to produce particular types of drawings. And you can definitely follow a traditional tutorial, you just might need to do a wee bit of translation or a wee bit of experimentation. And I'm going to be doing videos to try and help you with that translation moving forward, and those three sketching software packages, Rebelle 5, Sketchbook and Krita. If my next video is up, I'll put it in the corner. Otherwise, you may want to go watch this video on wave drawing, so you can draw waves. Definitely worth checking out, especially with regards to doing this tutorial. Thank you, and Wee Bob is out.